a really important place to start is what Nvidia does and what Nvidia does not do.
Sure.
Nvidia does not make quantum computers, nor does it sell quantum computers, but it does provide architecture, software and services to that industry. Just explain your role, please.
Yeah, so you nailed it on the head with the easy part, which is what we don't do. We do not build a quantum computer. But we have a vision about where how quantum computing will be useful. And it's really a point at which we have the integration of larger scale quantum technologies, quantum processors, as part of data centers and large scale computing that looks very similar to what we have today, right? If you look at today's large scale computing infrastructure, it's CPUs and GPUs and storage and memory and interconnects. And it's very complex, but very heterogeneous. And each part plays the role that it's best suited for, including the CPU and including the GPU. Quantum technology offers promise to be very good at certain kinds of computation, and so that will be an additional element of that system and come in. And so what we're focused on is really helping the quantum tech companies who are building those technologies to better develop those technologies, because we're interested in solving the problems that it will be able to solve, but also setting up that infrastructure to be the best partner to that quantum device, to be able to do things like error correction, calibration of the devices. These are, in some ways, things you can think about as physics experiments upon which we try to compute as much as a computer. And so managing that physics experiment and getting the right results out of it is actually a complex computational task that we look to our AI-accelerated supercomputers to actually perform.
What we are literally talking about here is a computer scientist or engineer at a quantum computing company with access to some of your GPUs in whatever form factor. Could just be the single GPU, could be scaled up to that server design, which we know as DGX. Right. What's the market there? You know, how widely is your technology being used in parallel with many of the quantum names that we saw today?
Yeah, so who we saw on stage today was a great selection of our partners who are all engaged with and who all are using GPU technology as well as accelerated computing technology, including the software stacks and other components that we develop, in their research program to simulate their devices and build better versions of their QPUs, to work with their clients and work on algorithm design by simulating a quantum computer, and also doing the fundamental research to drive towards that vision that I just discussed a minute ago, where we actually have this tight integration of these devices together. That involves work on the interconnect between the QPU and the GPU. That involves developing new methods for error correction that can be deployed at scale on a large supercomputer using novel AI methods, among many other areas. But those are not our only partners in this ecosystem. We're working with over 160 groups in quantum computing, and the range of application areas is quite wide, but they're all using NVIDIA technology to accelerate their work, because that's what we're ultimately here to do.
So we started the day with the idea that NVIDIA's technology can help quantum computers accelerate their own timeline, reach that useful metric. But the idea raised and put to Jensen Huang by those partners was actually the output of a quantum computer, in other words, the computation, can work both ways. Yep. It could be submitted for use in the training of a foundation model.
Sure.
What do you make of that?
Yeah, so I think that there's two sides of AI and quantum, and they're both really important and really fascinating. And what I touched on a few minutes ago was the AI for quantum, right? Using AI models to actually control and error correct larger and larger and more capable quantum devices. It's incredibly important, and it pulls in the timeline on useful quantum computing.
Yes.
Now, the other side that was brought up today, and it's a fascinating topic, is, you know, what is a quantum computer if you start to boil it down? And I won't try to go too far down, but they're really physics experiments, as I said. You're modeling quantum physics in the device, and so they're able to potentially provide data to train and fine tune models for understanding the very phenomena which are inside of a quantum computer, in a way which will answer questions that humanity has been unable to answer. So we think that that's a really interesting and exciting area to pursue. And we're engaged with our partners across all these different areas.
I don't think that in the context of all the attendees I've spoken to today and Jensen and the panelists that we've kind of reached definitive agreement on what useful is. But I think we've definitely reached agreement within your industry that this accelerates what's happening.
Yeah.
Pardon the pun, accelerated quantum computing. What happens next for NVIDIA and their footprint in quantum? There is going to be a research center in Boston. Those can often be abstract things, but why is that an important step?
It's an important step because one of the things that we have to do if we're going to build a new kind of computer, and if we add a quantum accelerator to a computer like what we build today. That is a new kind of computer. You're adding a new compute element. That is a physical endeavor. It has a footprint. It needs a place to do it. Now, the center in Boston won't be the only place that happens in the world, but it's a place where some of our partners and us can work on developing the interconnect, developing the error correction technologies, literally string up their quantum devices to our GPUs and build the first versions of these quantum accelerated supercomputers that we're all working towards.
Your view on what is useful, what do you think that a quantum computer will be able to achieve, whether it's assisted by NVIDIA or not?
Sure. I think that one of the most important things that Jensen talked about today on stage was really narrowing the focus and deciding what the problem is so that you can define success and chase after it. I do think that there's fairly wide agreement in the community that one of the first areas is to be accelerated and to have new kinds of problems solved that weren't before is in chemistry, biochemistry related areas. There's some kind of sniff test this passes, right? You've got basically quantum physics in the quantum device and the ability for that to model quantum physics in terms of what's required for very accurate chemistry just kind of makes sense. So we think that that's going to be the first area that's disrupted, or at least I do. I'm sure there's people on my team who disagree with me. As we saw today from the panelists, there are a wide variety of opinions on everything in quantum, but we think that's promising.